Though the Belgian priest and astronomer Georges Lemaître proposed the Big Bang theory in 1927 itself, the first direct evidence supporting the idea didn't come until 1965. Two Bell Laboratories scientists, Arno Penzias and Robert Wilson, were testing a Horn antenna which detects low-level microwave radiations. They discovered a low level of microwave background noise, which produces snow on a television screen. They couldn't get rid of this static hum no matter what they did, and even thought that it was caused by the droppings of pigeons roosting in their apparatus. Later they found that Princeton University physicist Robert Dicke had predicted that there would be a residual microwave background radiation, left over from the Big Bang. It was then they realized what they found was the fossil of Big Bang, the cosmic microwave background radiation. So as we discussed in the previous video, if the universe is indeed expanding, in the past, all the matter and energy in the universe would have been concentrated in a very tiny region of unimaginable density and temperature. Somewhat like the air in a bicycle pump, which heats up as it gets compressed. The CMBR is radiation left over from such an extremely hot and dense early universe that would have existed shortly after the Big Bang. Yet another evidence supporting the Big Bang picture of a hot, tiny early universe is the abundance of hydrogen and helium in the universe. During the first minute or so, the universe would have been hotter than the center of a star, when the entire universe would have acted as a nuclear fusion reactor. Later on, when the universe expanded and cooled sufficiently, this should have left a universe composed mainly of hydrogen, and about 23% helium, with traces of lithium. This is consistent with the Big Bang model. So where did the other elements come from? All heavier elements have been created by fusion inside of stars and during supernova explosions.